Hello and welcome. My name is Luke Lavez, and today we'll be taking a look at the TMS Web Bluetooth library. Here's what we'll be covering. I'll give you a quick overview of Web Bluetooth and Bluetooth Low Energy, and also be covering our goals. We'll then take a look at how to set up your device and also interact with that device. This will include reading and writing data to and from a BLE characteristic, turning on and off a LED, and reading real-time sensor data using the notify method. Why Web Bluetooth and Bluetooth Low Energy? With more than 20 billion Bluetooth devices being produced in 2019, including all current laptops, smartphones, and TVs, Bluetooth is already integrated into society and ready to go. With its low power consumption, Bluetooth Low Energy is great for projects which need to run batteries for extended periods of time. Web Bluetooth utilizes JavaScript in the browser, meaning we can code our program once for it to be available on many different devices. Our goal is to make Web Bluetooth development easy, with simple to use and easily understandable tools allowing for a quick setup and configuration of all your devices. This all within the Object Pascal language. For this project, I'll be using the ESP32. This is a microcontroller with built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth functionality. Using the Arduino IDE, I can create my own services and characteristics. Let's take a look at the setup. When I press Setup Device, I'm creating a Bluetooth object called BT. To this object, I can add a list of services I intend to use using the filter service list. This is a security feature built into Web Bluetooth, and failing to add them here will deny you access to them. We can also define by name specifically which device we want access to using the device name setting. In this case, I've chosen for the custom ESP32. This will filter out all other devices during the pairing phase. Now we can use anonymous methods for the rest of our setup. We'll take our Bluetooth object and call the getDevice method on this. This will return us a device to which we can form a connection to the GAT server. Once a connection has been formed, we'll once again take our device, but this time call the getService method on it, passing in a service UUID. This returns a service. To this service, we can then call the getCharacteristic function. This time I'm passing the int UUID to return a characteristic and place my characteristic into the variable int characteristic. I've done the same for LED characteristic, temperature characteristic, and humidity characteristic. When I press the read value button, I'm taking the int characteristic we created during the setup and calling the read method on it. This returns an integer a value. A value is then cast to a string and placed within the web label read value. That's this one right here. To write to our int characteristic, we can press the write value button. We'll once again take the int characteristic we created during setup, and this time call the write int method, passing in an integer value. In my case, I've got the integer from my web edit. Okay, let's form a connection with our device. When we press the setup device button, we can choose which device we want to pair to. In my case, it's the custom ESP32. I'll form a connection by pressing pair. And now a connection has been formed. So I'll want to have a look at which value is stored within the int characteristic by pressing read value, which is 800. And now I can also write a value to my ESP32. In this case, I'll be writing the value of 42. There you go, 42 has been written to int characteristic. So the value of 42 is now stored within the int characteristic. So if we press read value, we'll get 42. So we can write to and from characteristics, but what can we actually do with this? Well, for instance, we can turn on a LED. If we write the value of 1 to our LED characteristic, it will turn the LED on. And if we write the value of 0 to our LED characteristic, it will turn the LED off again.
Here's my ESP32 with an onboard LED. If we press the turn on LED button, we'll be sending the value of 1 to our LED characteristic, which turns on a blue LED. And if we press the turn off LED, we'll send the value of 0 to our LED characteristic, turning it off again. Here once again is my ESP32, but this time I've connected a relay to it, connected on the same pin as the LED. So this time, when I turn on my LED, I'm not only turning on the LED, but also turning on a fan. Which I can then turn off again.
Through the TMS Web Bluetooth library, we can wirelessly interact with real-world devices through the browser. We can turn on and off devices, even apply settings to those devices, like the color or intensity of a LED. We can even set up devices to speak with each other. For example, a temperature sensor telling a fan to turn on once a certain temperature has been reached. For our final demo, I'll be showing you how to get real-time sensor data readings using the notify method. During setup, we created the temperature characteristic and the humidity characteristic. To these characteristics, we can add an onNotify method. This is an async function. When triggered, we'll send a value to our form. In this case, it's the onNotify double, which will send a double value to be displayed on the form. To start readings is as simple as pressing the Start Readings button. This will take our temperature characteristic and also the humidity characteristic and call the startNotify method. To stop them, we can just press our Stop Readings button and apply the temperature characteristic.stopNotify and humidity characteristic.stopNotify.
Using the temperature and humidity sensor connected to our ESP32, we can now display real-time sensor data readings in our browser. Let's press Start Readings. There we go. I can increase the temperature of my sensor by placing my finger on it. And once we reach a certain temperature, it will turn the fan on.
That concludes our demo of the TMS Web Bluetooth library. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And stay tuned for further updates and developments from tmssoftware.com.